Hey guys, welcome to Tutorial Hub. I am Aadi, your tutor. Today we are going to start our first lecture on calendar problems. This is an important topic for several exams. So we start our lecture with agenda of this lecture. In this lecture, we are going to learn some basic concepts about calendar, and then we will see some important things about calendar that we should remember to calculate the answer quickly. Because as you all know, exams are all about speed and accuracy, and at last we'll solve some questions. Now we'll see some basic concepts about calendar. First is leap year concept. Leap year is nothing but a year which is divisible by 4. For example, 2004. Last two digit of 2004 is divisible by 4. So whole number is also divisible by 4. And another one is 2012. It is also divisible by 4. So, it's a leap year. One more thing is, leap year has 366 days. Second is ordinary year. A year which is not leap year is ordinary year. So, obviously, ordinary year is not divisible by 4. For example, 1989, it is not divisible by 4, and 2005. It's also an ordinary year. Third is century year. Century year is nothing but a year which has last two digits 00 or which is divisible by 100. The important thing to learn is for a century year to be a leap year, it should be divisible by 400. For example, 1600. 1600 is divisible by 400. So, it is a leap year. And another one is 1200. 1200 is also divisible by 400, so it is also a leap year. Now fourth concept is odd days. Odd days is nothing but extra days after completion of a week. What does that mean? It means suppose we have 10 days, and as we know, a week has only 7 days. So we have 3 extra days. These 3 extra days are odd days. Okay, now we see some concept related to odd days which we need to remember. First is ordinary year has one odd day. But question is how? See, we know ordinary year has 365 days and a week has 7 days. So if we divide 365 by 7, we'll get the remainder 1. And this remainder is odd day because it's an extra day. Another concept is leap year has 2 odd days. As we know, leap year has 366 days. So when we divide 366 by 7, the remainder is 2. So leap year has 2 odd days. Next one is odd days can have value from 0 to 6. Why? Because 7 odd days together will become a week. So odd days values are possible till 6. Next is 100 years have 5 odd days. I show you how this value get calculated. As we know, leap year is divisible by 4, so that means every 4th year will be a leap year. So if we divide 100 by 4, then we will have 25 leap years. But where is tricky part? 100 is a century year and it should be divisible by 400 to being a leap year. But as it is not divisible by 400, so it is not a leap year. So we'll minus 1 from 25. That means we have 24 leap years in 100 years. And 100 minus 24 is 76. So we have 76 ordinary year. As we have already seen in previous screen, ordinary year has 1 odd days and leap year has 2 odd days. So 76 plus 2 multiply by 24 equal to 124. And we know that odd days maximum value is 6. So we divide 124 by 7. Then it gives us 5 odd days. Next concept is 200 years have 3 odd days. We can calculate it easily. We have seen 100 days has 5 odd days. So 200 days will have 5 multiplied by 2 equal to 10 odd days. And after dividing by 7, we get 3 odd days. Same for 300 days have 1 odd days. 5 multiplied by 3 equal to 15, then divided by 7 gives us 1. And the last one is century and leap year has 0 odd days. Suppose for example we take 400 a century year, and we know as it is also divisible by 400, so it is a leap year. And how can we calculate it? See, we know 200 years have 3 odd days. Then for 400, it is 3 multiplied by 2, which is equal to 6. And also, it is a leap year. So there will be one more extra day. So we'll add this extra day also. So we got 7 odd days. And after converting it in weeks, there is 0 odd days. Okay, now in this next slide, I have mentioned theoretical values of each day. Like Sunday has 0 value, Monday has 1 value, Tuesday has 2, and so on. Also here I have provided the list of odd days according to months. January has 3 odd days. Why? Because January has 31 days. And when we divide 31 days by 7, we get 3 remainder. So January has 3 odd days. For February, we know it has 28 days when it is an ordinary year. And it has 29 days when it is a leap year. So odd days are accordingly 0 and 1. And the same way we can calculate for rest of the months. Okay, if anybody face issue remembering how many days a particular month has, so I give you a trick. See, this is the fist of a hand, so always count this way. January, February, March, April, May, June, July, and then again, August, September, and so on. So whenever in counting, you come to knuckles, then that month have 31 days. And when you come in between knuckles, like here, then that month will have 30 days. Only exception is February. Okay, so in this way, January will have 31 days, February is exception, then March has 31 days, and so on. Okay, now we solve a question. Question says, what day of the week was 30th November 1989? To solve these types of questions, always try to find out first the nearest possible maximum century leap year. I'll tell you why. Here, maximum nearest possible leap year is 1600. Okay? Then we have 300 more years and 88 years, and then we have more 10 months, 13 days. Okay, now we know century and leap year has 0 odd days and 300 years have 1 odd day. Then divide 88 with 4 and we got 22 quotient. So that means 88 years has 22 leap year and 88 minus 22 equal 66 ordinary year. So that means total number of odd days is 76 plus 22 multiplied by 2, which is equal to 110 odd days. Then we'll have 11 months. So we know January has 3 odd days, February has 0 because 1989 is not a leap year. Then March has 3, April 2, May 3, June 2, July 3, August 3, September 2, October 3, and for November we need to take 13 because date is 13 November. So total is 37 odd days. Then final total is 1 plus 110 plus 37 equal to 148 odd days. But odd days can only between 0 to 6. So we divide this number by 7 and remainder is 1. And as I told you earlier, 1 means Monday. So 13 November 1989 was Monday. Now next question is, if 30th April 2006 is Sunday, then what will be 30th April 2106. Okay, here we can see the gap between both the dates are exact 100 years. And we know 100 years have 5 extra days. So if in 2006 that was Sunday, then in 2106 it will be 5 days ahead. Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday and Friday. So answer will be Friday. Okay guys, that's it for today's lecture. If you want PDF of this lecture for notes purpose, you can drop me a mail on tutorialhub11@gmail.com. You can follow this channel on Twitter. Please like Facebook page of this channel for important updates about upcoming videos. Thanks for watching this video. If you like this video, please thumbs up and subscribe for more videos. This is Aadi, your tutor, signing off. Bye-bye.